Calorimetry is used to measure amounts of heat transferred to or from a substance. A calorimeter measures that heat transfer. To better understand this concept, let's say that this hot coffee is the system and your cup is its surroundings. Your system is whatever you are investigating or examining, and its surroundings is whatever is coming in contact with that system. So say if we were to pour our hot coffee into our cup, then the cup becomes warm, right? That makes sense. The cup is now warm because that hot coffee is releasing its heat to the cup. So your system is releasing its heat to its surroundings. So we can say that Q of our system is equal to the negative Q of our surroundings. Q just refers to heat. The heat of your system will always be the opposite sign of the heat of its surroundings. Now, let's say if we were to have this beaker with water at 25 degrees Celsius and a copper penny at 55 degrees Celsius. If you drop that penny into the water, then the penny will release its heat to the water until they both have the same final temperature. Key word right there, final temperature. They're both gonna have the same. All right, so that goes on to another formula where Q metal is equal to the negative Q of your water. Recall that Q is equal to MCAT and Q is your heat, which is equal to the mass times the specific heat capacity times your change in temperature. And your change in temperature is the final temperature minus your initial temperature. All right, so this formula expanded looks like this. Okay, let's try one. A 32.5 gram sample of copper at 45.8 degrees Celsius is placed into 105.3 grams of water at 15.4 degrees Celsius. What is the final temperature? And you're given the specific heat capacities of copper and H2O. Let's identify our other givens. Your first given is the mass of copper, which is 32.5 grams. We're given our specific heat capacity of copper and your initial temperature of copper, that 45.8 degrees Celsius. You're also given your mass of water, specific heat capacity of water, and your initial temperature of water. The proper formula for this specific type of example is our heat of our metal is equal to the negative heat of your water. Expanding this formula, because you know that your heat equals MCAT, or the mass of our metal, the specific heat capacity of our metal, and our change in temperature. Remember, change in temperature just means your final temperature minus your initial temperature. We're going to set that equal to the negative portion of our mass of our water, specific heat capacity of our water, and the change in temperature of water. Plugging in all the values that we found before and changing this change in temperature to T final minus T initial, just our initial temperature for both of these values. Next, we're going to multiply 32.5 and our 0.385 together, as well as these two values with our negative. And this is what you get. Instead of distributing and having this big old long problem, what we'll do instead is actually divide by 12.5125 to each side. That'll make this a lot simpler. We'll cancel these two out and divide these two values, and you get this. Next, I'm going to distribute now. Distributing this in, just multiplying. We get this. We have two T finals. Combine like terms, just like math. So I'm going to add over that 35.218 T final to the opposite side because there's really a 1 in front of that T final. Combine those two values and add over the 45.8 to the opposite side. And this is what you get. Next, we'll divide both sides by that 36.2108. Dividing both of these This would then cancel, giving us our T final, which is 16.2 degrees Celsius.